So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's session guys, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 28th to 30th of November 2022, and with this we will complete the month of November 2022, right? Ab December hum shuruaat karenge agle session se. So let's begin with the session guys without any delay, and let's talk about the very first question, which says, recently the Ministry of Power, which is headed by Mr. RK Singh, Rajkumar Singh, right, has launched scheme for procurement of aggregate power of 4500 megawatt. So you have to identify the correct statement about the scheme. Now from the name itself, the objective of the scheme is very clear, that the Ministry of Power is going to procure electricity, is going to procure power from the power generation plants. Of course, कहां से procure करेंगे? Power generation plants से करेंगे, right? So let's talk about this scheme. क्या है ये scheme? क्यों launch की गई है? What is the objective? So the Ministry of Power has launched scheme for procurement of aggregate power of 4500 megawatt under its Shakti policy. Shakti policy क्या है? इसके बारे में आगे बात करेंगे. But अभी के लिए just remember that it has been launched under the Shakti policy of Ministry of Power. Now this scheme has been launched to help the states that are facing power shortage, and also to help the power generation plants who are, you know, jinki capacity kam hai, who have the low capacities, right? So basically what will happen is that the Ministry of Power will procure the electricity from the power generation plant and then will supply to the states which are facing the shortage of the electricity power. All right, so I hope the objective of the scheme is clear. Now the nodal agency for this scheme, basically the implementing agency for this scheme will be PFC Consulting Limited, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of Power Finance Corporation Limited, which is a Maharatna company, right, under the Ministry of Power. Now already PFC Consulting Limited has invited bids for the supply of 4500 megawatt power. Electricity will be procured on competitive basis on 5 years on finance own and operate basis, right? Supply of electricity will commence from April 2023. Till then procurement will be done, aur uske baad supply ka kaam shuru hoga. And Ministry of Coal has been requested to allocate around 27 million tons, right, million tons coal for this. All right, so that is all about this scheme. Isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai, because ye koi bahut zyada deep mein jane wali scheme hai bhi nahi, right? So let's identify the correct statement. Electricity under it will be procured on competitive basis for 10 years on finance own and operate basis under Shakti policy. Is it 10 years? I don't think it is 10 years. Let us check it. Right, it is 5 years, right? So this is incorrect. Supply of electricity will commence from April 2025 under it. This is also incorrect. This is April 2023. This is what, April 2023, all right. NTPC is the nodal implementing agency, is that so? No, it is PFC Limited, all right. And Ministry of Coal has been requested to allocate around 100 MTPA. No, that's again incorrect. So all the statements are incorrect here, which means option E, none of the above will be the correct answer, because we have to identify the correct statement, and no statement is correct here, all right. Moving ahead to question number, okay, Shakti policy के बारे में बात करना रह गया. Shakti policy के बारे में बात करते हैं. Yes, Shakti policy क्या है? It is scheme for harnessing and allocating coal transparently in India. There is a full form of Shakti, scheme for harnessing and allocating coal, right? K stands for coal here, transparently in India. Now this policy was launched in the year 2017 by replacing the new coal distribution policy of 2007, right? Basically, it is a coal distribution policy, and it had replaced the new coal distribution policy of 2007, right? And the objective is to ensure the availability of coal to all the thermal power plants, and to ensure that the benefits of linkage coal are transferred to the end users, right? And of course, the ministry is the Ministry of Coal. All right, I hope Shakti policy is also clear. Let's talk about question number 2. Identify correct statement about rehab project, which is reducing human attacks using honeybees, right? That is the full form. So let's talk about project rehab. So remember, Khadi and Village Industries Commission, खादी एंड विलेज इंडस्ट्रीज कमीशन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डू रिमेंबर दिस, दैट दिस रिहैब प्रोजेक्ट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय केवीआईसी, खादी एंड विलेज इंडस्ट्रीज कमीशन, एंड हु इज द न्यू चेयरपर्सन ऑफ केवीआईसी, रिसेंटली आई हैव टोल्ड यू गाइस दिस, सो प्लीज राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द न्यू चेयरपर्सन ऑफ केवीआईसी. सो इट इज इन न्यूज बिकॉज केवीआईसी हैज इनॉग्रेटेड रिहैब प्रोजेक्ट एट चौसला विलेज इन हल्द्वानी डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ हल्द्वानी विच इज इन नैनीताल डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उत्तराखंड, राइट. You should remember this place, Chosla village, which is in Haldwani, and district is what? Nainital, right? So this project has been launched, rehab project. Now, what is this rehab project? It is to reduce the human-animal conflict. Basically, elephants. What happens in this is these are bee boxes, right? These are bee boxes. So ye bee boxes, jo railway tracks hoti hai, uske along hum lagate the. So what happens is ki elephant agar idhar aa raha hai, to usko bees ki awaaz se wo dur chala jata. All right, that is all about this object. So why? For fencing of bee boxes on the routes of movement of elephants to block the path of wild elephants. Aur wo kaise dur jate? By the sound of bees. All right, let's talk more about it. The objective of this project, rehab project, is to thwart elephant attacks in human habitations, thereby reducing the human-elephant conflict. Using honeybees and thus reducing loss of lives of both humans as well as elephants. It was launched in the year 2021 and its pilot project was launched in Karnataka. Karnataka mein iska pilot project launch hua tha. Implementing agency, I already told you, it's KVIC. And it is a submission under KVIC's National Honey Mission. National Honey Mission ke under ye ek submission hai. Alright. So what happens under it? As I told you, fencing of bee boxes are installed in areas from where elephant move towards the human settlement, and from those bee boxes, jo elephant hai wo dur chale jate hai because unko jo bees ki awaaz hai usse problem ho jati hai, right? In this way, through honey bees, elephants are prevented from attacking humans and destroying the farmers' crops and the human settlements as a whole. All right, and it is currently being implemented in 7 states, which are Karnataka, Maharashtra, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Uttarakhand, Assam and Odisha. These are the 7 states where this project is being implemented. Alright, so let's come back to the question then. You have to identify the correct statement. It is a submission under National Honey Mission. This is correct, no problem. It was launched in 2021 by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. No, the ministry is Ministry of MSME and it is being implemented through KVIC. Under it, fencing of bee boxes is installed to prevent elephants attacking humans and destroying farmers' crops. This is also correct. It is being implemented by Animal Welfare Board of India. No, KVIC hai. And it is being launched in 7 states. So this is correct. 1, 3 and 5 is the correct answer. Option C. Alright, option C is the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. Let's move ahead to question number 3. Question number 3 is, where was the National Conclave of State Finance Commission recently organized by National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj with support from Ministry of Panchayati Raj headed by Giriraj Singh? Alright, so where this conclave took place, that is the basic question. So remember, it took place in Hyderabad, which is in Telangana. Hyderabad, which is in Telangana. Now, what was the objective of this conclave? The objective of this conclave is to chalk out an actionable roadmap to professionalize the state finance commissions, right? जो स्टेट फाइनेंस कमीशन होते हैं, एंड प्लीज डोंट कंफ्यूज स्टेट फाइनेंस कमीशन विद फाइनेंस कमीशन जो सेंटर वाला होता है, राइट, वो दोनों अलग अलग बातें. सो टू मेक द स्टेट फाइनेंस कमीशन मोर प्रोफेशनलाइज, ये कॉन्क्लेव ऑर्गेनाइज कराया गया था बाय द नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट एंड पंचायती राज इन कोलैबोरेशन विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पंचायती राज. ऑलराइट, नाउ द फोकस एरियाज, the focus areas of the discussions were these. Number one, devolution formula adopted for the local governments, which means power coming from up to down, processing and decisions on state finance commission recommendations, right, issues and implementation of SFC recommendation, because generally what happens is that at the local level the recommendations of state finance commissions are not taken seriously, right. Coordination between SFC and Central Finance Commission recommendation and implementation. ठीक है, क्या उन दोनों के बीच में कोई conflict तो नहीं है? And SFC recommendations on improving the local governance. All right, so basically to strengthen the State Finance Commission, this national conclave took place in Hyderabad in Telangana. All right. So therefore, the correct answer is option D, Hyderabad. All right. Moving ahead to question number 4. Pavilion of which union ministry was awarded for outstanding contribution towards public communication and outreach at 41st India International Trade Fair, which took place at Pragati Maidan, which is in New Delhi. Pragati Maidan, which is in New Delhi. Right. So this pavilion was the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, headed by Mansukh Mandavia. And can you tell me, अभी हमने कुछ टाइम पहले ही डिस्कस किया था, which were the partner states in the India International Trade Fair? Please write down in the comments. जिनको नहीं पता है, no problem, I'll tell you guys in the next class. Question number 5. Which of the following organizations has released a study report titled Carbon Capture Utilization and Storage Policy Framework and its Deployment Mechanism in India? Now remember guys, in this report you don't have to go into the details, that is not at all required, because usme hamare koi bhi aisa point nahi tha jo ki exam point of view se important, right? Just remember that this report was released by Niti Aayog, option C. Question number 6. Who had recently organized 2-day workshop on Janjatiya Anusandhan Asmita Astitva Evam Vikas in New Delhi? Right, so that's very direct question, and I believe you can easily identify the answer. It's National Commission for Scheduled Tribes, which is a constitutional body under Article 338A of the Constitution of India. Okay. And the last question for today. In which state, 10 mobile health clinics, which are named as Dr. Aapke Dwar, were recently inaugurated under REC Limited CSR. Jo REC Limited hai, uske CSR responsibility ke andar Dr. Aapke Dwar launch kiya gaya hai. So the question is, in which state it was launched? So it was launched in Bihar. Option A is the correct answer. So that's it for today's session, guys. And if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel. You can join the Telegram channel. And the link for that channel is provided in the description. Description mein iska link hai. So please join that channel and get the PDF. Alright. And that's it for today. I'll see you in the next session on Monday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.